Hello everyone, welcome to Botany Option Channel for the UPSC examination. In today's video, we are going to see the International Code for the Botanical Nomenclature, alright? That is the ICBN. In this lecture, we are going to see how the botanical nomenclature work and what is the code for this botanical nomenclature. Now, first of all, what is the botanical nomenclature? A botanical nomenclature is the system of naming the plants scientifically in which each plant gets the scientific name. That is, the botanical nomenclature is the system of giving names to the plants and which are very scientific in nature. That is, the botanical nomenclature primarily deals with the nomenclature of the plants only, right? So the International Code of Botanical Nomenclature shows the rules and regulations for the nomenclature in the plants. All right, here we have example of a Mangifera indica, that is the mango. This name Mangifera indica is abided to the International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. All right. So botanical nomenclature has the very important function of naming the plants in a very scientific way. All right. So what is the history of this nomenclature? As you may have heard about the Carolus Linnaeus published a number of books on the taxonomy. The most notable of these are the Systema Naturae, which is published in the 1735, then Genera Planterum, which is published in 1737, which contains, and both this contains the artificial systems of classification of angiosperm based upon the characters of stamens. Alright. So this is the very basic and primary work done by the Carolus Linnaeus on the taxonomy, in which he published the two notable books, namely Systema Naturae and other is the Genera Planterum, in which he given out the artificial system of classification of angiosperm, and this system of classification is primarily based on the characters of the stamens. All right, but the most notable work of Carolus Linnaeus comes in his book called Species Plantarum, which is published in 1753, in which he has given the binomial system of classification. Now, in this binomial system of classification, the Carolus Linnaeus gives the key how to name the plants and how to name the animals. That is, the binomial nomenclature is a system of classification of plants and animals in which a scientific name consists of two parts, and that is why this nomenclature is called the binomial nomenclature. And the binomial nomenclature not only includes the plants but also includes the animals. So historically, the Carolus Linnaeus was first to classify and name the plants and animals as well, and that is why the Carolus Linnaeus is famously called as the father of taxonomy, right? So Carolus Linnaeus being the pioneer of the systems of classification and giving name to the plants and animals, and hence it is popularly called as the father of taxonomy. All right. Now, what is the history of ICBN, that is the International Code of Botanical Nomenclature? How this International Code of Botanical Nomenclature come into the existence? All right. In many literature, say 1867, Paris Congress is treated as the first International Botanical Congress. All right. And the code is given by this Congress is called as the Candolle's Code, alright. But in other books, or say in other literature, the 1900 Paris Congress is considered as an first international botanical congress, and this Congress gives the Vienna Code, alright. Maybe there is a debate that when first botanical congress has held, whether in 1867 or in 1900, but the worldwide rules and regulations of the botanical nomenclature arrive at the 5th International Botanical Congress held at the Cambridge in the year 1930. All right. So the 5th International Botanical Congress held at the Cambridge in 1930 gives the code which came to know as the International Code of Botanical Nomenclature. So today's ICBN came into the force in 1930 in the 5th International Botanical Congress held at the Cambridge. All right. Now let us see the principles and the rules of the International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, which came into the existence in 1930, which is the 5th edition of the International Botanical Congress. All right. Now, the International Code of Botanical Nomenclature is based on the 6 principles. That is, the International Code of the Botanical Nomenclature is based on the 6 principles. Now, first principle is, the botanical nomenclature is independent of the zoological nomenclature. As you know, in a botanical nomenclature, what we do, we name the plants scientifically, all right. But what we do in a zoological classification, we scientifically name the animals, right. And there is also International Code for the bacteriological nomenclature in which we scientifically name the bacteria. All right. So there is not only the botanical nomenclature, that is the International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, which is responsible for naming the plants. There is also International Code of Zoological Nomenclature, which is responsible for the naming the animals. All right. And then there is another International Code of Bacteriological Nomenclature, which name the bacteria scientifically. All right. So first of six principles in a International Code of Botanical Nomenclature is that the botanical nomenclature is totally independent from the zoological nomenclature. Now, the second rule of botanical nomenclature is the principles of names of taxonomic group is determined by the nomenclature types. Now, in a group, there are certain representative species which act as a source of name for that group, right? Now, for example, you may have heard about the Brassica. Now, this Brassica is the type for the Brassicaceae family, right? So, in a group, there are certain representatives which act as a source of a name, like the Brassica, which is belongs to the Brassicaceae family. So, the second rule is that the application of names of a taxonomic group is determined by the nomenclature types. Now, the third rule, the nomenclature of a taxonomic group is based upon the priority of the publication. That literally means, now, in 1936, one species A has been named as ABC, right? Now, after some time, that is in 1960, the same species A is named as XYZ, all right? But in this case, 1936 species, which has already been published with the name, this name taken into the granted as an valid name, all right? So, the nomenclature of the taxonomic group is based on the priority of the publication. That is, when the publication happened, the earliest the publication, earliest name will be the validated, all right? That is, the name which is published in 1936 will be the valid, and name which is repeated for the same species published in 1960, not accepted for the naming the plant, all right? That is, very important role is played by the date of publication. So, the date of publication of a plant name acts as a very important characteristic to whether valid that name or not. And the name which is published earliest will be considered for the naming of plant. All right. So, the third rule is the nomenclature of a taxonomic group is based upon the priority of the publication. All right. Now, the fourth rule, each taxonomic group with a particular circumscription, position and rank bear only the one correct name. That is, the name of particular group, including the generic name, it appears only once and it would not be repeated. But on the other hand, the specific name is allowed to be repeated. All right. That is, the generic name cannot be repeated, but the specific name can be repeated. All right. We can take the example for this as Mangifera indica and the Azarlecta indica. Both have the similar specific name, and the species name can be repeated, but the generic name cannot be repeated. That is, the Mangifera and Azadirachta cannot be repeated. So the fourth rule says that the each taxonomic group with a particular circumscription, position, rank can bear only one correct name. That is, one taxa can bear only a one correct name, and the generic name cannot be repeated, but the specific name can be repeated. All right. Now, let us see the fifth rule of the International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, that is, the scientific names of the taxonomic group are treated as a Latin, regardless of the derivation. That is, the every scientific name given to the plant, it should be considered as a Latin. All right, it should be given in a Latin language. And if the any plant which has not been given in a Latin language name, that name should be Latinized. All right, that is, if the name of the plant is given in some other language, that words should also be Latinized. So the fifth rule is scientific names of the taxonomic group are treated as a Latin regardless of their derivation. All right. Now the sixth and the final rule for the International Code of Botanical Nomenclature is rules of nomenclature are the retroactive unless expressly limited. All right. Retroactive means which is came into the effect from the previous date. That is, the rules of the nomenclature are retroactive. These rules can go back and apply to the past time as well. All right. So the species, which is discovered in 1830 and have published its name in a Latin language, that name can also be considered as a valid by. So that is the rules of a nomenclature are the retroactive in nature unless expressly limited. So thank you very much for watching this video. Please like the video. If you have any doubt, please comment. Please share this video with your friends who are studying the botany subject. And please subscribe to the Botany Optional channel for the UPSC examination. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the next video.